kids. Have good fun. Wait here, I'll try this.
Yeah, oh, sorry. This is an awkward moment, Mr. Mellon, since I realize you're a highly respected member of our business unit.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Our student body here is handpicked by me from the creme de la creme. Students all across this great land.
That's one of the things I like about this place.
Yeah. The point is, since you have no high school diploma, and no transcripts of any kind, no SAT scores, and you're 3 to 4 years older than our average freshman, how can this university ever see its way clear to accept you as a student? As Calvin Coolidge once said, the business of America is business. And the business of an educational institution such as ours is to create young minds that understand that the business of America is the kind of business that it actually is. Whatever it is that I have sent you today, the point is that we are here to honor our most generous benefactor and newest freshman, the man who's made it possible for us to break ground here today, Mr. Thornton Mellon.
Dean Martin, great speech, great speech. There's nothing like good, clean business, huh? And a little monkey business.
So glad you could make it. Mr. Mellon, I'd like for you to meet Dr. Philip Barbey, who's the dean of our school business.
David, I just want to get it on record that I'm totally against this. I don't think that selling admission to an obviously unqualified student is very ethical or honorable.
All right, Phil. But I'd just like to say, in all fairness to Mr. Mellon here, it was a pretty big change.
It's a simple matter of this man's presence undermining the efforts of our legitimate students, who are here as a result of hard work.
Hard work? Listen, Sherlock, while you were tucked away up here working on your ethics, I was out there busting my hump in the real world. And the reason guys like you got a place to teach is because guys like me donate buildings.
I wasn't speaking to you, Mr. Mellon.
I don't think Dr. Barbey understands the actual amounts that are involved here. Mr. Mellon, will you take the ceremonial shovel?
Thank you.
Dig into the symbolic dirt.
I hereby dedicate this building to myself.
Straighten them out. look, Chaz, there's a lot of people waiting. It wouldn't really be fair, you know?
I'll tell you what. Maybe if you got a note from each and every one of these people saying that it was all right, then we'd reconsider. But until that day, take a hike, you elitist fraternity scumbag.
I will forget this, Mellon. I'll see you at the pool. Bye now.
Bye.
Thank you. I'm good.
Yeah, and see, I figured out OBS studio software, which was giving me a problem before, but I got it figured out, so now I can run the two cameras. I was trying to figure out how to incorporate my audio interface so I could do guitar and stuff with studio sound.
Hey, you guys got everything you need?
But I kept crashing my computer.
Hey, what's with the used books?
What's wrong with used books?
They've already been read.
Yeah, and they've already been underlined too, get it?
That's the problem. The last guy who went by me, he could have been a maniac. Hey, get these guys some new books. Get some new books, will you? I'll tell you what, charging me too, okay? Here, pick a card. And I'll tell you, I'm taking four of those school sweaters, a bunch of pennants, some of those beer mugs, a few of these fuzzballs you cheer with, and... Hey, folks, it's on me. Shakespeare for everyone, okay? You too, honey. Ooh, I like to tame your shrew.
Who is that?
That is Mr. Thornton Mellon, the world's oldest living freshman, and the walking epitome of the decline of modern education. The stupid part thinks he can buy his way out of the gutter.
Oh, I don't think so. I think he was just having fun.
Oh, really? Well, I can't wait to get him in my class. We'll see how much fun he is then.
Oh. Hey, Mr. M. You're all set. We've been working all night long with that
Oh, thanks, Buzzy. I appreciate it. But add a few hundred to the bill and throw you in a voiceless party, okay?
Hey, you know what you've done?
It rubbed off from you, Buzzy. Say hello to Sonya for me, huh? Hey, I want to talk about my schedule. Look over it later.
Concentrating on finance a little later in the term. For the time being, Let's just concentrate on the construction figures, shall we?
You will see the final bottom line requires the factoring in of not just the material and construction costs, but also the architect's fees and the cost of their servicing.
Oh, you left out a bunch of stuff.
Oh, really? Like what, for instance?
Well, first of all, you're going to have to grease local politicians for the sudden zoning problems that always come up. That is the kickback to the carpenters. And if you plan on using any cement in this building, I'm sure the team should like have a little chat with you, and that'll cost you. Oh, and don't give them something for the building inspectors. Then there's a long-term cost, such as waste disposal. I don't know if you are familiar with who runs that business, but I assure you it's not the Boy Scouts.
That'll be quite enough, Mr. Mellon. Maybe bribes and kickbacks and mafia payoffs are how you do business. But they are not part of the legitimate business world. And they're certainly not part of anything I am teaching in this class. Do I make myself clear?
Sorry, just trying to help.
Now, notwithstanding Mr. Mellon's input, the next question for us is where to build our factory.
How about fantasy land? First class, isn't it good, huh?
and Gibraltar as a girl, where I was a flower of the mountain. Yes, when I put the rose in my hair like the Andalusian girls used. But shall I wear red? Yes. And now he kissed me under the Moorish wall, and I thought, well, as well, here is another. And then I asked him with my eyes to ask again, yes. And then he asked me, would I yes to say yes, my mountain flower. And first I put my arms around him, yes, and drew him down to me so he could feel my breast all perfumed, yes. And his heart was going like mad, and yes, I said, yes, I will, yes.
Yes! Yes!
Thanks for the vote of confidence. I think George is pretty hard too. And now that I've got your attention, I'd like to write down the reading list for the semester. See what else turns you on.
The jets? Can the jets open? No.
No, I like teachers. Do something wrong to make it.
No, they don't open. There's pictures of them on the build gallery. Have you guys seen the build gallery?
I gave away all my pens. I'm sorry, I need this back. And here's a calendar for you.
Hello, Mr. Mellon.
Are
you waiting for me?
Yes, I was. Look, I know I'm only a freshman, but what do you say you and I have dinner tonight? We could talk about Joyce. She's my favorite writer.
Well, you're not the usual freshman, but I'm sorry I can't. The thing is, I'm sort of going to something.
Well, where are you going?
That's a good question. Actually, I'd like to join you, but I have class tonight.
How about tomorrow night?
I have class then, too.
I'll tell you what, then. Why don't you call me sometime and we'll have no class?
All right. Maybe I will. Hello, Philip.
What did you want?
Oh, what a warm young man.
He wants you to dress up as Wonder Woman, tie him up with a golden lariat, and force him to tell the truth.
No, just dinner, Philip. Are you jealous of Thornton Mellon?
Certainly not. I've been doing a great deal of thinking lately. I've been thinking about us. I think we should start thinking about forming a, well, a merger, a partnership. Cyril and Diane were both intelligent, well-educated adults. We should be together, incorporated, if you will. Look at the balance sheet. We were made for one another.
Oh, darling, I don't want to be merged or incorporated. I want to have fun and be romantic. Be loved. But let's not rush into anything. Let's just start by having fun, okay?
Hey, how are you? What's happening?
A lot of people are talking about your dad.
Hey, what's happening? Hey, boys, how are you doing?
I wonder why. They have lockers. You could have changed here.
I don't change in front of guys. And the next thing you know, you're showering with the fellas. And the next thing you know, you're pinned to a sophomore named Chip. Come on, let's go.
I'll see you later.
Hey, looking for the fountain of middle age. What's your story?
I've set the new record for the most consecutive losses by a diving coach in this conference.
Hey, remember, hold that pipe longer.
Are you kidding?
Yeah.
Who coached him in high school?
Goes truly.
So where did you learn how to dive?
Atlantic City. Steel Pier. I was in a water show. I used to open for the diving boys.
I'm from Jersey.
Yeah.
I practically spent my entire life on that pier growing up. You know, if there was a guy did the most amazing dive called the Triple Lindy, like the hardest dive I ever saw in my life. Now, who was that guy?
Yours truly.
You're a kid.
Well, I don't joke about dives. Especially that one. It almost killed him.
Boy, you were sucking out. Can your kid do that dive?
Nobody can. It's too dangerous.
You know, he tried out for the team last semester. He didn't do that good.
Well, not that good, huh? Watch this. Jason, do the two and a half.
Trying to reuse some of these scraps of masking tape. That was close.
I mean, please try to understand. I don't have a background for this. I mean, the high school I went to, they asked a kid to throw the law around and he threw the teacher out the window. I know what I need. I need a tutor. Hey, what do you say? Come on. Well, you got some spare time.
All right, Mr. Miller, I got some spare time to see you. Why don't you come around about 7?
Some of the things on my list. What about Macbeth? I saw the movie. Orson Welles.
understand what you're saying, too.
Okay,
let me see. I got an idea. Let's keep talking a little bit.
I'm supposed to meet someone. I could cancel, though. I guess. I mean, we are working, after all.
You can't work on an empty stomach.
You can't concentrate when you're hungry. I don't know. I really shouldn't. I have so many things to do.
Oh, come on. I'll help you. I'll take out the garbage. I'll do the dishes. I'll do your nails. I'll do your hair. You have no idea what I want to do.
I'll call him.
I'm tired of it.
Light.
I think I'm attracted to the teachers. I took out an English teacher. That didn't work out at all. Sent her a love letter. She corrected.
Oh, great company.
Those two want to get a room.
Really?
Actually, I was married twice. My first wife, Jason's mother, I really loved her. We had a good thing going, you know. She passed away about 10 years ago. After that, I screwed around for a few years. I really went nuts. I married Vanessa. I was just lonely, I guess.
Is that over now?
Oh, we were doomed from the start. I'm an earth sign, she's a water sign. Together we made mud. Oh, I picked up beauty. She played around, too. When she said I do, I should have said with who.
So are you giving up on women?
I don't know. I can't figure women out. Today they're independent. They only think about themselves. When during sex, Vanessa, she used to scream out her own name.
I think it's a manhood. Ever since the women's movement, most of the men I meet go out of their way to show you how sensible they are. Or they were too macho, and now they're too soft. You all want us to know you can cry.
No, with women I never cry, never. I beg.
We finish this bottle of wine. He won't have to beg.
Thanks for the lesson, honey. I learned a lot.
You're welcome. I did too.
Well,
I guess this is good night.
Yeah. Very good night. Beautiful.
Come in.
Rossini. I'm Thornton Mellon.
Yes, Thornton Mellon. I know you. You delivered the paper on isomagnetic brain waves at Montreal last year.
No, I sold you your pants.
Oh, Paul, good to see you. What are you doing here?
I'm supposed to report here for my lab project.
Oh, good. I'm trying to teach these here apes how to read and write.
You ought to teach them how to go to the bathroom. That's the first thing you ought to do.
Oh, you'll get used to that. Now, all you have to do is put a new tape in the tape machine every hour and observe the animal. I'll be back in a few hours to check on you.
Okay. You'll need this. I'll find you an organ grinder. Hi, Marge. A few things. I need you and the gang to get down here as fast as you can. I have to talk to Peters, the accountant. I'll have to
get him. Stop!
Dad is having a little party tonight over in the dorm, and
it should be pretty great. Parties usually are, you know.
I'd love to come. Except I have a date.
Well, hey, bring them along. You know, it's okay. Both come by.
I'll really try.
Good. I hope I'll see you there.
It sounds like fun. I wish my dad were more like yours.
Good luck, buddy. Let's get them.
Yeah. Thanks, Miller. I wish you luck, too, but I guess a guy like you doesn't need luck.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, with your old man behind you. I figured since he, bought your way out of the team, he probably bought off the judges, too.
Oh, there's Thornton.
No!
Come on in!
I can't imagine what you can possibly see out there.
Philip, would you excuse me for a minute?
Yes. Oh, you look great.
Oh, thanks.
Where you been? I called you 100 times. Only 4 days with your answering machine.
Oh, I'm sorry I missed you. Things have been so hectic. I've been reading midterm papers and writing exams.
Did you read mine yet?
Not yet, but I'm looking forward to it.
Look, I'm throwing a little party in our room tonight. And you better be there.
Bento's my dog. Bento's my chocolate lab. He was barking at the FedEx man bringing a Chewy.com delivery. I have 2 dogs, Sasha and Bento.
Hey, buddy.
Whoa. Hey, baby, come on.
asleep.
You there. What's going on here?
Smell it, man. Story of the greatest party of all time. The whole world is there. It's the best thing that's ever happened to me in my whole life.
Oh, God. Look at that. Listen to that racket. This is disgraceful. I should phone security. Good. Apparently, I'm not the only one around here with a sense of decency.
Take a good look.
struck by something walking down the street. Oh, I forget what I used, where I used it.
Whoever did write it doesn't know the first thing about Kurt Vonnegut.
And another thing, Vonnegut, I'm going to stop payment on a check. What's that? Fuck me. Hey, Kurt, you read lips. Fuck you! Next time I'll call Robert Ludlum.
Derek, have you seen Jason?
I think he's on a 3-state killing spree. Oh, here's some more potentially bad news. Dean Martin was issued in his office right away.
Dean Martin.
And she said, let's do it. The room's already paid for.
Oh, golly. I'm afraid we have a potentially unpleasant situation.
Phil, would you repeat to Mr. Mellon the allegations that you've made to me?
It's clear the work you've handed in is not your own. I'm accusing you of academic fraud.
Such an ugly word, considering the financial generosity that Mr. Mellon has shown towards our fine university.
I think Mr. Mellon should be expelled. What are you going to do about it?
Well, Morton, I'm only going to ask you this one time. Is the work that you turned in your own?
I can't lie to you, Dean Martin. Yes, it is.
I'm satisfied.
I'm afraid.
Well, gee whiz, Phil, I just asked the man who worked his history, said yes. Now, what do you want me to do, torture him?
I suggest a comprehensive oral examination conducted by all of Mr. Mellon's professors.
Oral examination?
Yes. You've done the work you say you can. There should be no problem.
Hey, Lou, how you doing?
Come here, I want to tell you something.
What?
You was pretty hard on your father last night.
Oh, I know. The guy doesn't understand, you know?
Yeah, I know your pop 30 years. He understands. He's a nice guy. And he's tough. Like me. I'm nice and I'm tough. I'll give you an idea what I mean. My two boys, I put one through college, and the other I put through a war. Your papa loves you, hey? He's looking out for you. Look out for him.
Sorry, Jason. This college thing was a big mistake.
So you can give up?
I can't win. They want me to take oral exams, all my subjects. If I don't take them, they're going to kick me out. If I take, who knows where they'll pick me.
Hey, Dad, you remember what you told me when I told you I wanted to quit, huh? You told me that a man without an education is nothing.
I can't do it, Jason.
You can do anything you want to. Anything you want in life. Remember, you're a man. Thank you.
a special thanks, of course, to Mr. Thornton Mellon, who I do not have to remind anyone is the donor of our new Mellon Schools of Business.
We're wasting time.
You'll have 3 hours to complete the examination.
What do you say to a drinky?
Any part of it, you will be expelled. Mr. Mellon, do you understand?
The Councillor Trent.
Excuse me?
I missed a question.
We haven't begun yet.
Oh.
Well, Dr. Garvey, I suppose you're up first.
I'm trying, but she's so hard to buy for. Yep. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye.
£37.
I break in £27.
Excuse me?
Nothing.
Discuss the foundations of modern global business systems, part one. Define and differentiate the three economic philosophies of capitalism, socialism, and communism as pertains to A, management fundamentals, B, organizing and staffing, C, labor management, and D, production and operations. Part two. Are you getting all this, Mr. Mellon?
Yeah, it's a piece of cake.
Roman numeral 27, section 3, part 2 of subset D of the question. The answer is.
Now, with your fierce tears, I pray. Do not go gently like the night. Do
rage. Rage against the dying of the light.
Thor, what does that all mean to you?
It means I don't take shit from no one. I'm going to pass this test. I'm staying at school. Who's next?
Somebody heckling a guy.
Die.
has to start equal. So it's like everyone should go be able to go to the gym or use the best gym, use the same equipment, same food supplements, or whatever it is, but the outcome is never good. I read all of those comments. It obviously was very clear to me that you have not turned off your partisan and your ideological kind of mind. So what I would recommend very strongly for you to do is just to turn that off and to turn on the learning mind. I tell you that if I wouldn't be open-minded, I would probably still be in Austria yodeling. That would not be the Arnold Schwarzenegger that you know today. That only came because I was listening. I remember there was an event in bodybuilding. I just won a bodybuilding competition, and this woman comes up to me after the competition. She says, you know, I'm a ballet dancer. I would like to give you some recommendations of how you can do better and to guarantee that you always win competitions. Did you become the greatest bodybuilder of all times? And I said to myself, oh my God, what does she have to offer me? She doesn't know anything about bodybuilding. But in any case, I met her in her studio, and she taught me wonderful things about movement and the hands and the gestures and the facial looks and the direction the head should go and all of this stuff and how you move from the top to the bottom and how you switch from one pose to the next and the gracefulness. And I applied those principles. And it was unbelievable. I won championship of the championship. I won altogether 13 world bodybuilding championships. So I had an open mind. And the same was also in the movie business, because I remember so well Jim Cameron sent me, and I was right after Conan the Barbarian. I was riding high. We were number one at the box office, a lot of movie offers came in, and all of a sudden they got the script Terminator. I read it and I said, I'm not going to go and play a villain. I told my agent, I don't want to play a villain. I want to play a hero. I want to build a career as a hero. Then he said, well, why don't you meet with Jim Cameron? At that time, I didn't even know who Jim Cameron was. But I met with him. Well, the rest is history. We did Terminator. It was one of the most successful movies. It was a critical acclaimed success. So, I mean, it really helped my career, listening and playing that villain, and that the villain became actually very heroic in the end. And the same was, I was in government. When I was governor, I hired Democrats and Republicans because I wanted to serve everybody. I wanted to listen to the Democrats, what they have to say, so that I don't just have 50% of the opinions, but I want to have 100% of the opinions. So I always did that, and it really helped me. So I would just strongly recommend for you to do exactly the same thing.
Necessary funds by the end of the month. What is the deal?
And about Jock.
in addition to being my
terror.
End the stream for a short while.